Hi, I'm Slack, this is Tony, and welcome to Smogfog. Today we're going to be reviewing the Wismec Low RX Mini Kit. Kapow!
Mini, 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 mini.
And welcome back in the room, guys. Like the man said, the Wismec Rullo RX Mini Kit from Wismec. Now, the kit consists of the RX Mini Mod, which is an 80-watt sealed battery mod.
Yeah, and the Roo Mini Tank, which is a tidy little 2mm tank.
So, this being our new style of video review styly, there's no unboxing within this video. If you're interested in what actually comes in the box for it, check our other videos. They'll be around here somewhere.
Yeah, and talk about if you're interested in something, we always time code our videos, so skip to the bit you want.
Okay, so within this review, we'll be taking a look at the mod by itself on its own. Then we'll take a look at the tank as well by itself.
Yeah, and then we're going to finish off by looking at the kit as a whole, see how it performs, see how it fits together, you know, with things like our patent pending bro science heat test, all that good stuff. But for now, let's get things running by talking about the mod itself, the RX Mini.
Okay, guys, so we're talking about the mod first. So it's a tiny little mod that fits nicely in your hand.
Yeah, it really does, you know, little finger tucks under neatly and yeah, it just works really well. It's got a 2100 milliamp hour battery in it, which actually surprised me because when I was using it, I didn't actually read any of this stuff. I never read stuff, you know. I actually thought we were going to be looking at around the 3000 milliamp hour mark just from the performance I got out of it. So yeah, spoiler alert, you know, the battery performance is better than I would have expected had I known it was only a 2100 milliamp hour battery.
Okay, guys, with that said, let's move over now to power range, tech specs, features and protections. You're not going to say all that good stuff?
No.
He's not going to say it?
I said it enough already. We're about 5 minutes into the fucking video. Okay, so the unit's 44.5mm by 35.5mm by 58mm.
The output wattage is 1 to 80 watt.
It has variable wattage, bypass, temp control with nickel, stainless steel and titanium, and TCR mode.
Resistance ranges from 0.05 to 1.5 ohm for TC modes.
And 0.1 through to 3.5 ohms on variable wattage or bypass mode.
Temperature range goes from 100 to 315 degrees C.
That's 200 to 600 Fahrenheit for our American cousins.
Maximum output current is 25 amp.
It's got dual circuit protection, giving overcharging, overcurrent and over discharge protection. It's got atomizer over and under resistance checking. It's got short circuit protection. It's got PCB overheat protection and it's got the standard 10 second cutoff.
So, tech specs done. Moving over now to extreme close up for button pushes. So, basically interfering.
My finger is on the button. Well, technically, my thumb is on the buttons. This is going to be really awkward to show because of where they are, and also because I have giant hands that I'm going to have to press it with my thumbnail a bit. But without further ado, let's actually do some button pushes. So it's the standard affair of, in wattage mode, you turn your wattage up and down. You got your ramp ups, which I'm sure Tony has showed you. Nice ramp up. And ramp down the outs, that's pretty decent. So to get into your main menu, it's going to be three clicks on your J-Bo. And in you go, you see it flashing there. If you press the down button, that's going to cycle between the thing that is flashing. And you just select with the right button to change what it's doing. So I guess we'll change the mode. So at the moment, this has got the amp displaying down here, but you can change it to puffs and yeah, other stuff going on down there. Up here you've got your battery indicator. As a percentage, you can change that out for the old fashioned bar type. To change mode, go back to where it says variable wattage and just cycle through the mode. So you've got bypass mode. You know, you go above 0.1 ohms and you can just bypass it, so it works a bit like a mech. Temp control on nickel, temp control on titanium, temp control on stainless steel. Right, but before we come into TCR, let's just do regular temp control. So I've selected temp control nickel. You can then obviously cycle through and change the wattage that's running it. If you press the up button, then it will select it, and then you can go in and sort of dial it up and down as you require. As well as changing the wattage, you've got your ohm lock down there as well if you want that. And you can adjust the display down here as well. But that works the same across all three of the temp controls. Now let's do a bit of TCR in case you're not happy with the temp control performance. So scroll over until you get to TCR mode. There you go, and hit down. And then you can select which memory you want to use. And then you hit down, then you can adjust your wattage, you know, set the wattage that you're going to be using. You can then hit go. You can change the other things like your ohm lock. What you can't do is adjust your TCR from in here. To do that, you're going to need to power the unit off. So the standard 5 clicks. So now the unit's turned off, we press the go and right button for a couple of seconds, and that should get us into our TCR adjustment menu. There we go. You can press the uppy downy buttons to cycle through the various ones, then come into the memory you want with the go button and just up and down it. And job is good, and leave it a moment and that will sod off and do its own thing. Then you've just adjusted your TCR. Bit of a pain, but then we go back on. Along with the regular stuff, you've also got a stealth function, which is fire and left. Boom, stealth on. You know, it's nice with this small unit. You might quite like to have stealth, which may or may not stay on. There we go. You've also got a key lock function by pressing up and down at the same time. Boom, key lock. Still vapor away, just you're not going to be accidentally adjusting these. Not that you are anyway. Where are they? You can't even see them. They're there, look, there they are, but where are they? They could be anywhere. For people who like to try and read really small information upside down while they're having a vape, if you turn the unit off and press left and right, that's going to reorient the screen for you. So while you're having a vape, you can just sort of look down at all that information. So there you go. You can pretend you're watching the Star Wars credits as you're trying to have a vape. That's the information just sort of scrolls past. Dun, dun, dun. So yeah, come on, Wizmec, where's the yellow font coming in? You know, you've got this really cool Art Nouveau font. I really like this. Not Art Nouveau, Art Deco, shut up, Slack. Yeah, it's really cool. It looks like something out of Gotham, you know. It is just awesome. However, you know, if we had this in yellow so we could just scroll the fucker, that'd be awesome. And on that bombshell, it is back to the studio.
Okay, back in the room. So yeah, it's got the standard, you know, plastic Jabo button that you're going to find on your Relo RX200, RX200S, something like that.
Talking about the click on it, it's a bit different to the RX200S.
Yeah, it's a similar sort of feel, slightly less resistance, but yeah, it's a nice click. You know, you've clicked it. It's a little bit higher pitch for those who are bothered by such a thing, but I mean, it works nice and there's no button rattle, which is important.
The other thing that we've found in testing of this kit is that those button presses are reliable. We've had no misfires, not necessarily misfires, but mispresses, you know what I mean, like the side of the button.
Yeah, and generally when I've been using it as well, 5 clicks on, 5 clicks off, I haven't been doing the sort of 8 clicks until it turns on or off, you know, and I haven't accidentally been chucked into that 3-click menu like some other devices that we've been using lately. The up and down buttons being hidden on the bottom of the unit does save a lot of space on the front of it and probably helps keep the size of the unit smaller, but it does mean that for any adjustment it's going to be a two-handed affair. You know, you can't just sort of move it. Maybe you could learn to use your little finger or your monkey toes or something, I don't know, but for me it's certainly a two-handed affair.
Ding dong. Ladies and gentlemen, leave a like down below. So the three-click menu is fairly standard and intuitive, only setting the TCR value is a bit of a mystery.
Yeah, I couldn't work that one out for the life of me. I sort of went for all the presses. I figured it would be in the off. I just lost patience with it. And eventually, we would have got there. But everything else, you know, though being a little bit different with the whole uppy-downy button to select things, it just makes sense. You know, it's easy enough to pick up straight away without looking in the bookie thing.
So in testing, I mean, we found those uppy-downy buttons just a bit of a pain in the arse to get to. Not to find, I mean, you know exactly where the fucking are, but actually trying to get to them to adjust them. And we're going to find that more because in testing we have to change the temperatures up and down, the values. You've got to use it as a cycle through buttons. You've got to hold them both at the same time. It's just a lot of work involved in actually testing the thing to its fullest. And my fucking thumbnails really paid the price for it.
Yeah, same. I could only really press that with my thumbnail or just sort of massively jabbing all my thumb skin in there until it eventually pressed it. However, in day-to-day usage, yeah, you're going to find the wattage you like. Are you laughing at thumb skin? For fuck's sake. Ignore Tony. In day-to-day usage, you go find the wattage you like on the tank that you are using on it, you know, the Roo Mini. You know, I liked it at 50 watts. I set it at 50 watts and I'd leave it there. So you won't need to be using these all the time. They're nice and neatly tucked out the way. So it's kind of a catch-22. Tucked out the way, you're not going to be accidentally pressing them. But if you do want to press it, two-handed operation and a little bit fiddly.
Moving over to firmware updates for you, and yes, new functionality has been added with the preheat function.
Yeah, so obviously reading from that, yes, it is firmware updatable, which, you know, keeps Tony happy, and it keeps me happy too. That said, I think the initial firmware that's come out of the box is actually pretty decent. It sort of ticks all the boxes, it has all the functions. So it's good that they haven't released it before it's ready, just knowing they can fix it in a firmware update, but they're actually introducing new functionality still. That new functionality is coming in terms of this preheat function. Now, preheat functions can be used for one or two things, really. You can either give it a sort of gentle wattage for the first half, second, whatever it is, to gently warm up your coils. Now that's going to sort of preserve your coil life, because they're not going to go from freezing cold to like mega hot temperatures pow instantly. That's how you get them big pops and clicks out of them, you know, when you fire it from cold. So yeah, that'll help deal with that. That'll help preserve your coil life. The other thing you can do with preheat function is actually chuck a high wattage at it to get you up to temperature for vaping faster than, you know, the normal build up. If say you're 50 watts, then it's going to take a while to build up the heat at 50 watts, but you could punch 80 watts at it for half a second, so it gets it there that little bit quicker.
The added bonus there with the second one is that it will be excellent for the likes of drippers, having that punch straight away. So guys, moving over to temperature control for you, and as you've seen throughout, it does do the big three: stainless steel, titanium and nickel. Not only that, but it also comes with that added bonus of the TCR. So if you're not happy with the functions that they've set for you, you can adjust them to how you like it. The only downer there is actually being able to do it with jamming all your thumb skin in there. And thumb skin, that's another one of those words.
Yeah, for me, all the temp control settings out of the box were dead on. The only thing I would have a little niggle is that the nickel I found a little bit underpowered. The rest of it was pretty much exactly as I want it. You know, you can adjust the temperatures accordingly, adjust the wattage accordingly, and it worked very nicely, and it was none of that hard on, hard off. You said hard on. But it provided you with a nice even vape across the draw. Okay, so talking about the battery now. So it's that 2100 milliamp hour battery. And again, you know, we've already said this, but yeah, I was surprised by how well it worked for such a sort of low milliamp hour battery.
Yeah, in terms of battery life, while testing it, you get a good half a day's use out of it. Moderate use, is that the right word I'm looking for?
Reasonable use.
Reasonably moderate use.
Yeah, if I'd have known this was a 2100 milliamp hour battery, I'd have definitely had reservations about it, because, you know, we're into sort of not far off those micro devices, the 1100, 1200 milliamp hour ones, which are good for like an hour or something like that if you're sort of going at it. But yeah, actually, you know, it would get me a drive to work and a few vape breaks at work, and yeah, I'd charge it up before the drive home, and that wasn't from flat, so that was pretty good.
Nice little segue coming up here for you, because in terms of charging, it's got a 1-amp pass-through charger, so you can vape while you're actually charging at the same time.
Yeah, and being a sealed battery, you don't have to feel guilty about, oh, maybe I should be charging this in a dedicated charger, because you can't. You just plug in your USB cable, it'll charge you at 1-amp, and yeah, pass-through for those emergency top-ups, because we've all been stuck there, you know, desperate for a vape, stuck in the car or something, attached to a plug. In terms of charge time, you know, for this, I found it was best to sort of charge it when it was sort of reporting that it was like 25% sort of battery left, and it took just over 2 hours, under 3 hours, you know, and let's just say 2.5 amongst friends, you know, to get the complete 100% charge from about 25% flat, which is pretty decent, you know. Again, I would have expected longer. You know, we've had some of these batteries where it takes sort of 4, 5, 6 hours to charge, and you're just like, ugh. Yeah, and with a smaller battery, you know, 2100 milliamp hours, you wouldn't want something to take 6 hours to charge and only get a few hours use out of it. So that sort of fairly quick charge on it is pretty nice. One thing I did notice, you know, I was saying about I charged it from 25% flat. When it was getting down to, you know, I'd look at the battery indicator and it'd say like 46%. Then you'd have a vape, then it'd say 25%, and then you have another vape and it's back up to 43%. And it's a little bit all over the place. Obviously, it's going to be quite difficult to predict that in the numerical one, because, you know, you have a hit and that drains the battery, and the battery charge will change and it will come back and it will do a bit. But yeah, massively accurate, the battery indicator at the top. When it starts getting lower, it does get a little bit erratic. It's definitely not a showstopper, but you know, something we should mention.
Moving over to venting for the device now, it's got sort of like two lines of vent holes on the bottom of the mod, and you've got vents either side, pretty similar to the RX200. While the vent holes are on the side of the device look to be of a good size, the ones on the bottom look really fucking small.
Yeah, and with the battery already jammed up against, you can already see it sort of looks a bit blocked, so I don't have a lot of confidence in a device failure, in a battery venting, whether it would actually vent out of there or just block itself up. Hopefully, yeah, it's not going to be an issue, you know, because it's got all those protections and stuff built into it, so hopefully we won't get to a venting situation with these, but, you know, it's one of them just-in-case things.
All right, guys, mod is done. Moving over now to the Roo Mini Tank for you. The unit measures 46 by 22 millimeter. It has a stainless steel construction, giving it a nice sturdy feel for you. And it is fully takey-aparty. What is that? How did you say it again?
Disassemblable.
And it is fully disassemblable for easy cleaning. And if that interests you, have a look at our other unboxing review where I fully take apart this tank.
Okay, running down the tank, starting at the top, working our way down the bottom. Yeah, up top we've got this drip tip. It's a POM material, maybe Delrin, I don't know, I don't care. It's all the same stuff, but it's that standard 510 sort of drip tip with, you know, double O rings. Swap your own one out in the standard sort of format if you don't like it. But yeah, actually, it's pretty decent.
Talking about filling this sucker up, it's easy enough to undo that top and just drip in.
Last Tony hasn't been using it before you and tightened it up with his bear claws, because you can over tighten this, so a wimp like me would struggle to loosen that off. And while we're in the complaining about it section, also it's the construction. Once you've taken that top off, there's nothing to hold that glass on. You're just reliant on that washer. I've had no problems with it, but I don't like that as a design. I like something that sort of holds the glass. Again, you're going to forgive it because it is such a small unit, so you know it's going to keep the weight down. I understand why it's done, but still my least favourite kind of design.
Was that my fault as well?
You bought it.
And while we're talking about dripping juice into this little bastard, it is a 2mm juice capacity, so it is that whole TPD compliant bullshit that we've got to put up with in Europe.
Continuing down the device, we get to the coils. Now, in the kit, it comes with those two 0.2 ohm coils, and yeah, they're pretty decent, they work pretty well. Looking online for it, you can buy spare coils in packs of 5, and they come out pretty cheap somewhere around that region. Yes, we're not allowed to mention price, but you know, it's a pretty reasonable price for a pretty reasonable coil. However, if you're looking for Wismec Roo Mini coils, that's it for your options. There aren't any others. Now, hopefully that's going to change in the future, but at the moment on the market, that's all you're going to find. And they're not everywhere yet. Hopefully, again, that's going to pick up as the popularity of the device increases.
Yeah, the other thing we found with those 0.2 ohm triple coils, the fact that they look very similar to like the eLeaf iJust coils, and with iJust releasing those 0.18 ohm coils, that would have been a good option. I tried and it didn't work.
Yeah, they look so close, but yeah, same as saying about the screw threads not lining up quite right, and maybe you could get it in there, but you wouldn't get it out again. Yeah, comparing the coils that come in the Roo Mini, they're actually the Amor coils, so you know, there will be some other coil options that go fit in there, quite what they are, where they are, because they're quite hard to find in the UK, so we're not 100% sure, but certainly the Amor class coils will fit in here.
Moving over to airflow for you guys, and it's pretty decent for the size of the tank, because it's only a little mini little bastard, but compared to some of the tanks that we've been reviewing recently, it is a little restrictive.
The airflow adjustment's easy enough to control, you know, even when it's on the mod, which is nice. You know, again, some where they're sort of these micro ones, they're a little bit difficult, but I found it quite easy to turn it down. You can turn it down so it's practically 100% off, and so you can then control it for that mouth to lung hit. If you're coming from smoking cigarettes, then that's going to help, you know, being able to do the mouth to lung hit. So it does make this kit appealing for a sort of first time vapor, as well as, you know, people who've been vaping for a while.
Okay guys, moving over to leaks, bits and swallows for you. Now in testing we found it no leaks whatsoever, but a few minor spits, and when I say that, I mean it is very fucking minimal. Like, you've got to angle it at your tongue to be able to feel the vape is actually spitting ever so fucking slightly. Slack does point out though that if you don't use it for half a day, it's
a bit more spitty, you know, for the first sort of several hits. That's where I really noticed it. It sort of tuned me into it, because it had been sat half a day where I've been on other devices, and I was like, well, we've got a spitting issue here. But again, it's not terrible, it's not all the time, and it's certainly not a showstopper. I'm still using it. It's just, yeah, we noticed it, we mentioned it. Okay, it's time to talk about the kit as a whole now. So we're going to start off with our Bro Science, you know, heat test that we do, see how this runs, then we can talk about flavour, wicking, all that good stuff. But let's hit it.
And we're hitting it.
So it's running at 50 watts.
Sorry, I got that in your face there. No wicking issues so far.
Now, still getting a couple of the minor spits like we do usually.
Honestly, if you don't mind it, you won't notice it.
Tony loves people spitting in his mouth.
Wasn't going to go there, but as soon as we're there. Flavour is still on point with that coil.
Yeah, every hit after hit is the same. It's starting to get a bit hot.
What's getting actually hot?
The vape at the end of the hit is starting to get hot.
I'm all right with that.
Okay, I think this might do.
Agreed.
Now
that we've heat, lost the room.
There's a little bit of heat on the glass, a little bit of warmth on the drip tip and the top metal cap. The top metal cap is probably where it's the hottest. The mod itself feels cool. Lip test, yeah, the mod is completely cold. Base of the Atti is cold, not cold, but just only warm. So all the heat's just sort of sitting there on that filling cap, and it's not too hot. Considering this is a small unit, you know, there's not a lot of room for heat dissipation in there, I think it's handled it really well. And that's more than you're going to be vaping, unless you're at the pub and had one too many and, you know, hitting it hard. That's more than you're going to be vaping it on day-to-day usage.
So during that heat test that we just did, as I said, the flavour was on point. There was no wicking issues at all. It seemed that backwards and forwards, even at 50 watts for that 0.2 ohm triple head, it was fine. The flavour was coming through nicely every single hit.
Yeah, it does. During general usage, the flavour you get from this is decent. It is one of the better sort of coils for giving flavour. Probably not the best, you know, there will be better ones, but it is up there, you know, it is a nice flavour experience. Also, I haven't had trouble wicking that thicker e-juice, the 70-30s, the 80-20, stuff like that. It's worked really well. You've got some nice juice holes on the side of the coils, and it just works well.
So the next bullet point to cover off is portability, size and weight, which is fairly self-explanatory for this mini kit.
Yeah, I mean, it is brilliant. Just the way it fits in your hand is just so convenient. You know, your little finger just wants to tuck under it, so it's not going to drop out. You've got a good grip on it. That is somehow dirty. I don't understand why, but...
If there's a picture of a sausage on the screen... You'll get the idea.
But yeah, once it's in your hand, finding the button's not a worry. You know, obviously the adjustment buttons are a little bit more of an issue, but you don't use them. Once you've got, you know, this kit with this tank on it, it's you don't need to adjust it. You just use it. 5 buttons, easy to find. It's reliable. And it's such a dinky little unit, you'll be able to sort of fit it in your pocket, be safe, and, you know, carry it about. And the battery life on it sort of lends itself to going out of an evening with it, you know. Mm. So it works. It's a nice portable little unit.
Moving over to style now. So they've got a bunch of colour options for it. You've got silver, grey, white, black, red.
Yeah, and yeah, they all look pretty nice.
They do. In terms of actual style for the device itself, I mean, they've gone for just like a mini version of the RX 200S. I mean, if we hold that up there and that there, you saw it in the if you haven't seen it, go look at the unboxing video, because you get an up close look at both of them.
But yeah, I think that sort of RX sort of look on the Mini really does suit it. You know, it looks like a cool little unit. I like what they've done with the styling. I'm not too convinced by the spare bit of pleather that's included. I personally wouldn't want to go through that change to swap it out, but you know, maybe someone out there really likes brown leather and wants to swap it out onto the silver mod with the black screen and black button. Maybe.
Courses for courses.
Different strokes for different folks.
And a crappy bit of brown leather for weirdos.
Why haven't you put yours on there? Okay, and the last thing to mention is the warranty for this. Now, it does have a warranty, but it's going to be whatever your region or shop is providing us the warranty. They sort of state, you know, if you break it, you bought it, but if there's a manufacturing defect, they will hook you up.
Okay, guys, it's that time again where we sum up by way of pros and cons. Obviously, starting with the cons so that we're ending on those beautiful pros. First up for the cons list...
I'm going to go with the lack of coil choice at the moment that's specifically targeted to the RX Mini. I mean, the coils are good. These 0.2 coils are good, and they probably would be the ones I use anyway. But given that this kit would really suit someone coming from cigarettes, you know, 0.2 isn't necessarily where you'd want to be. I'd like to see some mouth-to-lung coils specifically at a higher resistance.
And while we're talking about coils, it's worth mentioning that spitty spit back on the coils that you get only if you're sensitive to that sort of thing, and it's not even that much.
Yeah, it's not all the time and it's not bad, but it's certainly worth mentioning, and we don't really need a prawn section here, so it can go in the cons.
Next up on the cons is those adjustment buttons on the bottom of the mod and having to jam your thumb skin in there to adjust the buttons.
Yeah, again, the flip side to that, you know, we like to find cons, but we also like to sort of say why they're not so bad. But if you're using this tank with this coil, you'll find the wattage that you like and the mode that you want to be in, you know, and you will just leave it there. And so it's not going to be a mega issue. And while we're talking about the adjustment buttons, adjusting TCR, I don't like the fact that you have to turn off your device and sort of stand on one foot and, you know, wait till the moon's in the correct position to be able to adjust your TCR. I do like... Everyone else seems to be going to this thing where you go into TCR mode and it steps you through all the things you need to do to set it up how you want. I much prefer that. It's a lot easier to use. It's not a showstopper because you can do it. And again, once you're happy with it, it's going to be fine. You're going to leave it. But it's just a pain. Next up on the cons list for me is that it's the poor tank design with the sort of nothing to support the glass once you've unscrewed the top to fill it up. Now, we've not had any issues here, so I do want to just sort of clarify that. But, you know, I have had tanks with the same design in the past where you unscrew the top and the glass tries to pop off and your half full tank of juice tries to empty out. So, you know, it's just not the best design, but again, no problems here.
Next up on the cons list is the fact that the venting on the device could have been done better. Another one that I've just thought of is the fact that the construction of the stainless steel tank and the body of the mod itself, the silver, don't match. I've just thought of this, even though I actually said it in the unboxing. It is a con. That fucking drives me up the wall. The fact that you've got two different types of metal look.
Yeah, not a con for me.
And it's going to be different for everyone. Okay, yeah. Guys, that's about enough ragging on it. Now we'll move across to the pros. First up has got to be the size. The fact that it fits in the hand so nicely.
Yeah, also the shape lends itself. And this is another one of the pros. The shape really does lend itself to sort of work with that size to fit in the hand really nicely. It makes the go button easy to find, and it makes, you've got a good grip on it. And that whole portability size and weight thing, I think they've nailed here.
Next up for the pros is that battery life, and the surprise that we both had that it was only a 2100 milliamp hour battery and how long that lasted us in testing with moderately heavy usage.
Next up on the pros list, it's just got to be the sort of functionality of the device. Not only is it, I mean, it's a mini kit. Quite often mini kits are just sort of like, you know, you get it and that's just whatever, it'll fire a little bit. But this has got bypass mode built into it. You know, it's nice to have that. It's got three memory modes for TCR. Not only that, it's firmware updatable and they're already introducing new features into it. So, you know, for a mini kit, for something that, you know, could just be a wattage only device, you know, they've really sort of thrown everything at it.
And so the last pro that we've got for you is the fact that Wismec have managed to produce this unit to perform so well in a smaller package. It just feels like they've taken the larger unit and put it in a shrink machine.
Yeah, it really does sort of give that, you know, you don't feel like, apart from holding it in your hand, you don't really feel like you're using a mini device. Yeah, the flavour I get from these coils is good. It's, you know, it's definitely up there with something I would use all the time. And not only that, it deals with the heat well, which again is surprising for a small unit.
Okay guys, so summing up for the RX mini kit from Wismec, it's a tiny 2100 milliamp hour battery with a 2mm tank on top that we both really like. Guys, thank you for watching. We hope you like what you're seeing and what we're doing. If you do, please drop a like and do the whole subscribe thing because it helps us out a lot. Also, follow us on the social media, Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. We are quite
chatty. Also, if you've got any questions about this device, you can hit us up in the comment section below. Find us on social media. Also, if you are on social media and you've enjoyed what you've seen here, please give us a share because sharing is caring. But for now, guys, thanks for watching Small Vlog. Yeah, okay, what is this? Just the RX Mini kit. Yeah. Rulu. Rilla Ox. Ox. RX Mini kit.
What, are we doing this episode in Swedish or something?
You're in your eye.
How do you go in flaring snake?
You need to read it some more, because apparently that will help.
Wismec. Wismec? Wisemec. Wisem egg.
Are you doing like a Stewie from Family Guy? Do you want some Cool Whip?
Cool Whip?
I'd love some Cool Whip.
So, Wismec.
Do you want me to do
it? Wismec. 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 Right, ready?
Is this genuine or...
Come on, man. Head in the game.
Man down.
Oh.
So nearly ready.
And back in the room. So in terms of button quality, it's got that standard J-Bo, you know.
I didn't know J-Bo had a... Leave us a comment down below if you knew J-Bo had a... Like everyone else, I'm wondering how much a... is going to cost me.
We can't talk about price in Ross since the TP.
Oh, but we can give sort of like a ballpark figure though.
£20 out back.
Ladies and gentlemen, form an orderly queue.
TCR memory. Now, TCR is a little bit complicated, so I guess we'll just show regular. I've gone into it. Balls.
Deep.
It's just a...
It has a stainless steel construction, giving it a nice sturdy feel for you, and it is fully taking a party. What is that? How did you say it again?
Disassemblable.
You've got detachable written up there, and now all I'm fucking thinking is, it detaches, but that just means take it off the mod. Disassemblable.
Yeah.
It's probably not.
That's so silly.
I know. That's why I think you should say it.
Ready?
Yep.
And it is fully disassemblable.
Help, my thesaurus is broken.
Do you know my dog's got no addiction? How does it spell terrible? Again, you're going to forgive it because it is such a small unit, so you know it's going to keep the weight down. I understand why it's done, but still my least favourite kind of design.
Was that my fault as well?
You bought it. I was perfectly happy using my fucking crown from 2 years ago. And then you hand me this thing, and I'll have to use something different. We fear change. Anyway.
Yeah, ready?
2 mL juice capacity, making it tippy. I haven't finished talking to you yet. Can't start while I'm talking. Won't edit out. Don't start while I'm talking. Okay. 2 mL, TPD compliant.
Talking about the click on it.
I hit the mic.
You did.
But if you do want to press it, two-handed operation and a little bit fiddly.
Jamming all your thumb skin in.
It's like trying to thumb in a soft phone. Like feeding a marshmallow through a door lock. I'm scared of the shelf now when I take the piss out of you with your fucking Buzz Lightyear karate chop action. Right, okay.
So as you saw there during the heat test, I mean, flavour was on.
How did they see the flavour?
Smell-o-vision?
Taste the rainbow.
Touch it.
That's something different.
Next up for the pros is that battery life and
I think I keep looking down here instead of at the camera. I think I've got camera shyness.
That's how they teach shy people to actually talk to people. So don't look at your eyes, look at the bottom of your nose, because this close it looks like I'm looking at you, even though I'm looking at your nose.
Yeah.
what I quite like doing is talking to someone's ear. Because they can see you're not looking at their eyes, and they'll start moving into your head. But you follow that ear, they'll get so fucking paranoid doing like polite formal conversations and that. And just
what the fuck is wrong with my ear?
Like, fuck, did I leave an earbud in it or something?
Shit, yeah. Is this something about Mary? Is there something on there?
Where did it go?
Anyway. Now I remember someone was doing a review.